lying hand.
Uh-huh.
Now we're going to go farther with it, and we're going to come, and we're going to drink out of the sacred vessel.
Yes.
You understand that?
Yes.
The Bible says as they did what they were commanded.
Yes.
Brought the vessels and continued to drink.
My God.
The Bible said that immediately there appeared a man's hand.
Get that person.
And it started writing on the wall.
Yeah.
Now, as Miss Davis would say, this is a real cop killer. Y'all understand? I don't care how drunk you are. Now, you just see the hand. You don't see a person. You simply see a hand, and it's writing on the wall. Now, I don't know what they had drank, and I do know they had to be drunk. But the Bible said that they'll save us. Shake some sense into me.
Amen.
Trouble.
His knees began to shake.
Have mercy.
Mm-hmm. And being that he was the king,
yes.
He sent for the astrologers,
yes.
The soothsayers, you understand the hoodoo, the palm readers, sent for the magicians and all of them, and said, whoever would come and tell me what this writing is,
yes.
I'll give him to be the third ruler in the kingdom. No, that's all he had to give. He was the second ruler himself. So the third ruler, the third seat in the kingdom was what he offered for anybody that could interpret the reading.
Yeah.
Now, let me say this. He started the feast. He started the party. He started the banquet because of how big he was. It was designed to show honor to himself. It was designed so that others would recognize what kind of kingdom he reigned over. And now all of a sudden, handwriting on the wall made him not look so big. It troubled him. And I marvel at how the more God speaks to us,
all right,
the less trouble we become.
Amen.
The more we go against the will of God, how comfortable we become.
Amen.
How overconfident we are. Just assuming that since God let us get away yesterday, since God allowed us to get by last time, since God didn't call us into judgment last year, that we can continue to do the same old thing. Continue to disregard God. Continue to act as if though God does not exist. Continue to act as if though we woke ourselves up this morning. Continue to act as if though God does not see us. As if though God does not care. And God is still
right
on our wall.
Amen.
Said, when none of the astrologers, the soothsayers, or the magicians were able to interpret the reading, the mother queen came in and said, "Oh, king, don't be in trouble.
My Lord.
I know you don't remember. But there's a man by the name of Daniel."
Yeah.
"Oh Lord, when King Nebuchadnezzar had a dream, nobody could interpret the dream. Oh Lord, Daniel had a spirit in him, a spirit of the living God. And Daniel was able to interpret the dream. Now, don't let your heart be troubled.
Amen.
Oh Lord, just send for Daniel and see if he cannot interpret the writing." The Bible says when Daniel came before the king, the king said, "Are you that Daniel, oh Lord, that's able to interpret dreams? Are you the Daniel, fact that Daniel said is not in me, but there's a God who's in
heaven
who knows the heart. The scripture said that Daniel shut, began to interpret the dream, or interpret the writing on the wall. They said, God have numbered your kingdom. Give an account of